Hello and welcome to the future. I'm starting my rebranded channel with this incredible story about the incredible artificial intelligence, AI, chatbot called ChatGPT. This AI chatbot can generate text by utilizing a vast database of information that includes all the data that has been uploaded to the internet up to 2021. It has been utilized to compose a variety of texts such as poetry, high school history assignments, and website editorial content, etc. ChatGPT became publicly available in November 2022. Researchers have discovered that this AI chatbot is able to pass certain sections of the US medical licensing exam. Incredible. This raises the possibility of using the chatbot to assist in writing the exam or to aid students in preparing for it. A team at Ansible Health, a company that provides care for mostly homebound patients with chronic lung disease, initially aimed to use ChatGPT to aggregate communications related to these patients in order to improve coordination of care. Dr. Tsang and Ansible's vice president and medical director stated that the team decided to test ChatGPT's capabilities by asking it multiple choice questions from the U.S. medical licensing examination. They were so impressed with ChatGPT's performance on the medical licensing exam questions that they decided to publish the results as a preprint on MedRxiv. They stated that the team was shocked by the results and the chatbot was even allowed to contribute as a co-author on the publication. ChatGPT wrote sections of the introduction, methods, abstract, and results with minimal guidance from the human authors, and was also utilized to simplify and offer counterpoints to drafts in progress. However, the team decided not to credit ChatGPT as an official author. The article has been accepted in the peer-reviewed journal PLOS Digital Health and will be published soon. The National Board of Medical Examiners also commented on the study's results and stated that they were not surprised by the outcome, as AI like ChatGPT is most successful with multiple-choice type questions. Dr. Tsang and his team evaluated ChatGPT's performance by providing it with hundreds of multiple-choice questions from the three sections of the medical licensing exam. The researchers used three different methods to test the chatbot. First, they presented it with a theoretical patient's symptoms and asked for a diagnosis or underlying cause. Next, after resetting the chatbot, they presented the questions from the exam and asked it to select an answer. Finally, after again resetting the chatbot, they asked it to provide explanations for the correct and incorrect answers. The answers were then evaluated and scored by three licensed and board-certified physicians. Dr. McCabber from the U.S. Medical Licensing Program highlighted that the ChatGPT was only given a limited set of questions, not a full practice test. He also mentioned that the chatbot was not exposed to questions that required image or audio input, or case-based computer simulations which are included in Step 3 of the exam. Tsang in his article suggests that ChatGPT could be utilized as a study aid for students preparing for the USMLE or to compose questions for the exam. Dr. McCabber stated that the possibility of using ChatGPT as a study tool is being considered, but as the technology is still producing a significant number of incorrect answers, it is not yet ready for widespread use. However, the National Board of Medical Examiners is exploring the potential use of automated item generation and is investigating ChatGPT with interest and curiosity for its potential in the medical field. According to ChatGPT, while it is a powerful tool for understanding natural language, it is not a substitute for the specific knowledge, analytical thinking, and ethical considerations that are crucial for medical practice. The U.S. medical licensing exam is still considered an important and valid way to assess the knowledge and capabilities of future physicians, it stated. The research on ChatGPT's performance on medical licensing exam was done voluntarily without any external funding. Dr. Tsang, who was involved in the study, is also a full-time employee of UWorld, a company that provides preparation materials for the examination. This content came from an article I found on Medscape.com. The original article was written by Alicia Alt and published on January 26, 2023. I used ChatGPT to summarize the article for use on this video. The link to the article is included in the description. I'm worried about the future of education. So, what do you think? That's it, my friends. If you enjoyed this video, please share it with others and consider subscribing to my channel. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so that you will be notified whenever I upload a new video. Thank you for watching.